be an ice cube, but it will be a bubble cube. Time for the bubble cube! Jump!
They don't like to bump their heads, though. What I need to do is try to get my heart out. There. Now, be careful. Go slow. Remember what happens? They get nervous. They jump off into a ball. It's terrible.
Hands
together and thank you, Michael Johnson, for coming and sharing the
secret world of bubbles with us. How many of you have made bubbles already today? That's not a lot of
armpits. Okay, yes, yeah. Which is kind of gross, really, when you think about it. It means there's a lot of people out there not washing their hands or brushing their teeth. If there's a secret to the world of bubbles, it would be this. There are bubbles around us all the time, and it's just that we don't realize it. In fact,
and so what we'll do is I'll fuel them up, and then we'll launch them. You'll know when to say blast off when I count down. Three, two, one.
Blast off!
Because the film has more work to do. Smaller bubbles go right to that spherical shape.
Reach into the bubble. Grab hold. And if you're careful, try to pull the bubble out. Ooh, and that was called a mistake. Need to make sure your hand is very wet. Oh, it was so suspenseful too. Really below. Oh, here he comes. Come on, bubble.
There's some complex science going on here. Next, on Time Warp.
Well done. I was the first bubble artist in America to get a government grant to research, create, and perform a soap bubble show.
Paid by the government.
That is correct. These are your tax dollars at work.
You know, some of the things our tax dollars are spent on, bubble blowing seems like an efficient expenditure. It does have that cool thing going for it. Yeah.
The rule is dry things pop bubbles, but wet things don't. The colors are a map showing you that the film is thick in some places and thinner in others.
So just like a prism, we get the whole spectrum in every bubble.
When we warp one of Keith's monsters, it looks like a drunken amoeba. But once let go, it wobbles its way toward becoming spherical.
Go for it. So there it is.
It's pretty amazing.
You think of it as one event, instant event, but there you could really see the tear.
Hello. Hey,
how are you?
Wow, awesome.
Portable electronic devices must remain on.
You can make it look like jello. See how heavy it is, right? Turn it upside down and it's not too heavy. Or if you at all like I am, you spend half of your first week doing this, you go boing. Because if you're lucky, what will happen is they come apart. And then you can bounce them off of each other. Boing. Boing. We're trying to get them back together.
So we've been working with soap films of different sizes. And there's yet another one. So that's a soap film. You can see that one. That's like a hippie igloo. No, it's a soap film. It stretches out, but it pulls itself back in to be the smallest size it could be. It has tension.
All right, she's on the rectangle.
And she wants to go to the picnic over there. To get her to go there, we need to pop this side of the rectangle that she's standing on. Because that frees up the other side with its surface tension to pull in.
and it pulls the nose of the ant by the dry finger right along with it.
We'll see if we can get you in a bubble. Enjoy the colors. Yo, maybe we'll put you in a donut.
Wait, will it work? Not always. I always do try, though.
If there was a secret to the world of bubbles, it would be this. My friends, there are bubbles around you all the time. It's just that we don't realize it. In fact, those bubbles that you make when you wash your hands, when you brush your teeth, those bubbles are keeping you healthy. There are bubbles in the soda that you drink, in the bread you eat, in the clothes you wear. There are even bubbles inside of you that make you pop in a couple of different ways. Please remember this one thing, and that's everything that touches a bubble needs to be wet. Dry things pop bubbles, wet things don't. One last thing though, you can tell me, what is inside the bubble?
Air.
Air, perfect, which is a gas. And that's nice to say in public and not get in trouble, so I say it a lot, gas. Mostly oxygen, nitrogen, a little bit of carbon dioxide and stuff for the plants. And you breathe air, so if you make a bubble and then blow against the side, the film, you might be able to put another bubble inside. So it's still a liquid. With a dry finger though, I open a door, maybe I'll let them out. A sphere, round like a ball. Trapped air in a soap film, that's a bubble. Starts to make its own. So, yeah. Bubble pyramids. No. All right, bubble wild kingdom. The film is squeezing in. The gas is pushing out. But instead of popping it all at once, let's do a thought experiment. Instead of popping it, what would happen if I just opened a window on top? You have your idea in mind, keep it there and see if you're right. Are you ready for the grand finale? Yeah! You can make a bubble donut. The bubble donut. Look, I'm a munchkin. Hello. Hi. Although I forgot to ask you earlier, miss, are you allergic to soap and water?
No.
No, that's good. You know, I know some high schoolers that are, so I've always got to ask. And I think I'd like to encase you like a saucer. All right. Give it a try. And remember, science is totally awesome. I love science! Me too. Give yourselves another hand.